Sir Isaac Newton was born in 1642 and died in 1727. By the age of 26, he had made many discoveries in mathematics, mechanics, and optics. In 1705, he was the first scientist to be knighted. His book Principia Mathematica laid the foundations for physics that still apply today. All forces in nature have been categorized into the four fundamental forces. Forces act on everything in the universe, and therefore are used in the laws of physics. The gravitational force is the force that attracts all objects in the universe. It is the force that keeps the planets in orbit around the sun and keeps you stuck to the surface of the Earth. It has a relative strength of 1 and an infinite range. This force only has the ability to attract objects. The strong nuclear force is the force that holds the protons and neutrons together inside the nucleus of an atom. It has a relative strength of 10 to the 38th, a range of less than 10 to the negative 15th meters, and this force can either attract or repel. The weak nuclear force is the force responsible for the interactions involved, like nuclear decay. It has a relative strength of 10 to the 25th, a range of less than 10 to the negative 18th meters, and can either attract or repel. The electromagnetic force is caused by electrical charges. It has a relative strength of 10 to the 36, an infinite range, and can either attract or repel. It is present in magnetic forces, as shown by this magnet, or in electrical forces, like the static electricity stored in a balloon. Newton's first law of motion states that if the net force acting on an object is zero, the object will maintain its state of rest or constant velocity. A teapot on a tabletop can be used to demonstrate Newton's first law. The teapot is at rest because there is no net force acting upon it. The forces on all sides are balanced. The force of gravity is pushing down on the teapot, but the normal force, which is the perpendicular force between the surfaces of two objects in contact, is balancing the force of gravity. This is an example of when no net force is present, the object is at rest. To demonstrate an object at constant velocity, an air hockey table is used. The puck is constantly moving at the same rate because the friction acting against the puck is so low that basically there is no friction. This means that there is no net force acting on the puck and it will continue in the direction it was going. Newton's second law of motion states that if the external force on an object is not zero, the object accelerates in the direction of the net force. The magnitude of the acceleration is proportional to the magnitude of the net force and is inversely proportional to the object's mass. This means that when there is an unbalanced force, the equation acceleration equals force divided by mass can be used. Again, this law can be shown by using the teapot on the table. When a force is added in one direction, the friction on the table acts against it. If the force is larger than the force of friction, then it will cause the teapot to accelerate in the direction of that force. Newton's third law states that for every action force, there is a reaction force equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Using a Dodge Viper attached by a rope to a large block, Newton's third law can be shown. As the Viper accelerates, a force is exerted forward, but the block has an equal force backwards, causing no movement of either object. Thank you.